Hey guys, press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from Pink Villa.
Had a busy year? If you haven't had the chance to hit the fashion news yet, then we are here to your rescue. Hi, I'm Shikha, and today I bring to you some of the top news that happened in the fashion world in 2017. So you can go for the next party and throw some of these news at people's faces and say, bet you didn't know that. So let's get started. Let's talk money first. According to Forbes, Kendall Jenner has now become the highest paid model of the world, making a whooping $22 million in 2017. Kendall managed to end the reign of Brazilian supermodel Gisele, who was the highest paid model since 2002 up until 2017. Sources say that some of her income may be not just from her runway walks, but also from her massive Instagram following, her Adidas and Estee Lauder deals, and also we wonder how much money she made from that Pepsi campaign. In other news, plus-size supermodel Ashley Graham took a jab at the Victoria's Secret Angels. Ashley Graham is a wildly successful supermodel and has always been an advocate for body positivity. She strutted down the runway with angel wings in a doctored image that she posted on her social media. Ashley took a jab at Victoria's Secret as it is one major company that is yet to cast a plus-size model on their annual runway show. Speaking of Victoria's Secret's annual runway show, guess how much the Victoria's Secret Fantasy bra cost this year? Well, the amount may blow your mind as it is a whooping 13 crores. The 13 crore worth of Victoria's Secret Fantasy bra was covered in diamonds, yellow sapphires and blue topaz and was worn by Brazilian angel Ribeiro. Now, as all of y'all know, Anushka Sharma launched her own clothing line called Nush. But before she could even roll out the sales, she got caught in a plagiarism row. It seems the actress copied her designs from popular wholesale e-commerce websites, mostly Chinese websites. Now, either the designs were sourced right off the websites or the designs were copied. Hence, Anushka had to cancel some of the designs and not release the clothes that were caught as copied. Next up is a really weird one. Balenciaga, which is known to be really fashionable and chic, collaborated with Crocs. Balenciaga is not afraid of an ugly shoe. They released a 10-centimeter long platform Crocs at Paris Fashion Week, and I don't know who's gonna buy that. Everyone's favorite Rihanna launched her own Fenty Beauty makeup line, which was 2 years in the making. The foundations of the makeup line came in several shades to match each and every one in each and every skin tone. From the reviews that we heard, popular beauty websites and bloggers could not stop raving about how great the Fenty Beauty products are. Kudos, Rihanna. Marc Jacobs took the smartwatch to another level. He released a new smartwatch that can also let you take a selfie. How cool is that? The smartwatch is called the Riley Hybrid Smartwatch. It's innovative and cool and comes in many fashion-forward designs. All of you from Bombay who've lusted over Celine bags can finally get your hands on it as Celine came to India in association with a multi-designer branded store called Lermil. Now, we all know that India is raving and making a lot of noise in the international fashion scene, and one of the many iconic examples is Tyra Banks wearing Abu Jani and Sandeep Khosla. Tyra has been making a lot of news and noise ever since she became the host for American reality show America's Got Talent, and she's been stepping out in some fabulous outfits, one of them being her Abu Jani and Sandeep Khosla design. The dress had a plunging neckline and gota patti embroidery on it and was really reminiscent of Rajasthani roots. In other news, most of you Deepika fans must know, Deepika Padukone made her debut as the L'Oreal brand ambassador on the Cannes red carpet. Styled by Elizabeth Saltzman and hair and makeup done by L'Oreal Paris, the actress looked stunning in all her appearances. Now here's a little bit of bad news for all of those who love Kate Spade. Coach bought Kate Spade for $2.4 billion back in May. Now the problem that lies here is that the shoppers were not really happy about this Coach and Kate Spade collaboration, as both the brands have very distinctive styles. The good news, however, is that Coach said that they will retain the brand's employees as well as give it complete independence, hence retaining the styles and the signature style of Kate Spade. Another international fashion moment for India was when Deepika Padukone and Priyanka Chopra walked the red carpet for the Met Gala. Deepika's outfit got mixed reviews, but Priyanka, however, slayed the look in her long Ralph Lauren trench coat. Now here's another body positivity outrage that was caused. Dolce & Gabbana caught into some serious soup for writing thin and gorgeous on their sneakers. Designer Stefano Gabbana, one half of Dolce & Gabbana, posted a picture of the sneakers from their fall 2017 collection, and one of the many illustrations on the sneakers read thin and gorgeous. Of course, the followers of the designer reacted and said, "What the hell is that?" Of course, Gabbana shot back with those who disagreed with him and wrote, "Darling, do you prefer fat and full of cholesterol?" He also added, "Do you prefer fat and full of hamburgers? You need to rethink your choices." While some of the people were still outraged with the designer, some people reacted in a positive way, saying they really want the pair of sneakers right now. Giving competition to her beloved sister Kylie Jenner, Kim Kardashian launched her own line of cosmetics named as KKW Kim Kardashian West Beauty. Since Kim is known for her chiseled face and on-point contouring, she initially started by launching her own line of contouring sticks. Now, how many of y'all have seen Emma Watson's Beauty and the Beast and absolutely loved it? Well, I am one of them. But did you know that the costumes of Beauty and the Beast were made right here in India? Now, it's no easy task for designing 18th century costumes with French floral designs and look aesthetically right. As a part of her commitment to who made the clothes story, the assistant costume designer shared the story of the artisans from Bhuj. Now, for all those girls who rave and pray for being the Manish Malhotra bride, Manish Malhotra has something new. You can also wear his designs to cocktail parties now, as for the very first time, the designer launched cocktail dresses in his collection, which he showcased at the Lakme Fashion Week. Speaking of designers launching their new collection, Sabyasachi Mukherjee went completely digital and launched his Spring-Summer 2017 collection on Instagram. How cool is that? And that's it, guys. Those are all the major fashion news that we have from 2017. Now you guys are up to date and can go and throw your fashion knowledge around to everyone. If you like this video, then don't forget to like it. Comment below and let us know what other news do you know. We'd like to learn too. And don't forget to subscribe to Pinkvilla.